Good evening, everyone. My name is Chandra Jenkins. I'm the Director of Community Relations for Sodexo, leading Sodexo Foundation and the Stop Hunger Initiative, which mobilizes entire Sodexo communities, including employees, consumers, clients, suppliers, and young people in the fight against hunger. Let me first start by adding my thanks to all of you who have contributed to Sodexo Foundation and its mission to fight childhood hunger and to educate and engage youth in the movement. Without your generous support, we would be limited in our ability to fight hunger and its impact. Hunger hurts the person, the community, and the nation. And as Tom Nelson, president of Share Our Strength, recently put it, unlike so many problems, hunger is solvable. We have the food, we have the programs, and we have the leaders, our scholars and heroes. Every year, I have the distinct honor of seeking out Sodexo employees who have taken it upon themselves to improve the quality of life for those in our communities by fighting hunger. These individuals are from all walks of life and have felt a passion to invest their time, talent, and service spirit in helping those at risk of hunger. We call these individuals our Sodexo Foundation heroes of everyday life. Employees are nominated and evaluated on demonstrated impact, level of influence, the number of people affected, and the ability to engage others in the fight. This year, we have selected 6 outstanding individuals to be recognized as the 2013 Heroes of Everyday Life. In honor of their volunteer service, each hero will receive a $5,000 grant presented in their name to their charity of choice. Yesterday, as part of their visit to Washington, our heroes met with some of our nation's elected leaders on Capitol Hill, bringing their combined message of hope with a renewed sense of urgency. Our heroes told their stories and at the same time reminded senators that there are millions of Americans, including thousands in their home states, who are counting on them to support vital programs like the school breakfast program and the summer food service program. So now I would like to invite George to the stage as we present the 2013 Sodexo Foundation Heroes of Everyday Life. Paula Bailly, kitchen manager at Snohomish School District in Snohomish, Washington. For the past 7 years, Paula has been a powerful force in the fight against hunger. She has served more than 100,000 meals to almost 300 families at the Snohomish Community Food Bank. During the annual U.S. Postal Service food drive, Stamp Out Hunger, she helped transfer tens of thousands of pounds of food to local food banks. Paula has served over 8,400 meals to homeless men at the local gospel mission and persuaded others in her family to join the cause. Together, they pick up and distribute food, pack and pass out backpacks, and even give out Christmas gifts to families and individuals in need. In her close encounters with children in the schools, that is what has been her driving force, and Paula shares, "Working at an elementary school really opened my eyes to the needs of children. I feel blessed to be able to give back, and I really encourage others to reach out into their communities and help those in need. It's easy, it's fun, and it's very rewarding." Paula Bailly is a hero of everyday life. Jonathan Wilson Darling, General Manager at Erlanger Health System in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Jonathan has tirelessly waged the war against hunger. For the past 12 years, he has been organizing Stop Hunger efforts in Chattanooga communities. He started recruiting his peers in the fight against hunger in 2001, and today his local food bank includes 45 Sodexo volunteers. In the past 4 years alone, Jonathan's efforts during Sodexo Serve-a-thon have led to the donation of more than 100,000 pounds of food and more than $20,000 to the Chattanooga Area Food Bank. Jonathan also started a backpack food program. Last year, it provided 50 children at Orchard Knob Elementary School 1,250 backpacks full of nutritious food. Jonathan points out, "Seeing a need and knowing I can do something to bring about positive change is what drives me, whether it's an elementary school student or someone who receives a food backpack over the weekend or even a local resident benefiting from the food bank, that my team of volunteers and I played a small, important role in making this happen. It's a gift." Jonathan Darling is a hero of everyday life. Terry Denton, cook at Reynolds Army Community Hospital in Fort Sill, Oklahoma. When Terry was 7 years old, her parents took her to volunteer at a local homeless shelter, and a lifelong commitment to feeding the hungry was born. More recently, from 2000 to 2007, she has been cooking for Meals on Wheels. She's been serving meals at least 2 times per month at the Salvation Army since 2007. Each month, nearly 300 people are fed thanks to her work. And to date, she has served more than 27,000 meals in total. Terry also helps a group of underprivileged youth, taking them out for healthy meals each month and preparing nutritious sandwiches for them on the weekends. Terry shares, "Having the ability to do something positive for someone else less fortunate is as much a gift to me as it is to them." Terry Denton is a hero of everyday life. Daliana Gandarillas, marketing coordinator at George Mason University from Fairfax, Virginia. Daliana stands on the front lines in Virginia's fight against hunger. Since 2010, she has been rescuing, preparing, and serving food to those in need. Once a week, Daliana cooks hot meals at a local church. Every other Saturday, she helps a shelter serve breakfast. And on the last 2 Sundays of the month, she delivers hot dinners to the people on the streets of Washington, D.C. To date, she has served approximately 14,400 meals to the homeless and another 21,600 meals to the hungry at a local church. In addition, Daliana has a large group of volunteers to serve an annual Thanksgiving meal to those in need. Reflecting on her experience, she observes, "After serving thousands of hot meals to some of the most precious people, the homeless, it's challenged me to look at my life differently and to better consider what others might be going through." Daliana Gandarillas is a hero of everyday life.
I'm gonna be frank with you. I don't know what it's like to be hungry. kids that go to school hungry, they cannot function well. You know, it's hard to try to listen at a teacher or learn something when your stomach is growling.
We all have a calling. Al heard his.
We've been going out feeding the hungry for the last 12, 13 years, and it just become a desire in my heart to put together No Nonsense Ministry to do the same thing.
When I heard that what he was doing, it almost brought tears to my eyes.
No child should go hungry. No child should have to worry about where the next meal is coming from.
I've been hungry before. I know what it's like to wake up and not know where your next meal is coming from.
When I experienced hunger, it was just miserable. I was embarrassed to let people know that I was hungry.
It's hard to tell a person you know how they feel to be hungry when you ain't never been hungry. See, I done been there and done that, so I know. I can imagine and I know exactly what most of those people out there are going for. Eating out the garbage cans, eating out the dumpsters, begging for food. Everybody that's hungry is not homeless. One family, a lady, she had like three or four kids, and she was willing to let us know that she just can't make ends meet. It's a question of should I buy gas, or should I buy some food, or should I buy my medicine, or should I buy food, or should I keep the lights on? Some people feel, now it's just my personal opinion, that they're saying, well, those people could do better if they want them. Not necessarily the case. Maybe some of them out there could, but who is us to try to judge who can do better and who can't do better? Quite a few kids that come up and eat with us all, so sometimes the parents bring them and then sometimes they come by themselves. And one time I remember I asked a kid, I was like, where's your mom? And he was like, haven't seen her since Thursday, and we feed on Saturday.
Thank goodness, Paula, that he came in and stepped up to feed people, to care about people, and, you know, just be there for them.
Keep the line moving, please.
Yes, Alvin is an inspiration to me.
Hey, we have some bags if y'all just need something to tote your food in now.
Because he motivates me to do what he does.
Hey, don't forget now. In about 30 minutes, we got that spaghetti rolling out. All right.
His compassion for people, the love that he has for people.
Look at him come. Look at the little cheering come. Come on, y'all.
Just being Alvin, just being who he is and loving people.
I can't give you but one. I'm telling nobody I gave it to you, all right? Right.
When we're feeding the children, I see happiness because they're excited about getting in line. They are excited to receive the meal, a hot meal and a cold drink.
There's no reason that people should be hungry.
We could do better if we could just get out and get in touch with the community more than we are doing. When I hear the word hero, it's someone that goes out saving lives, as in, say, a paramedic, or a police, or a fireman.
You can see the glow in the people's eyes and when they can see that he's concerned about them.
I'm glad to be standing beside the CEO and the visionary leader of the No Nonsense Ministry.
I see us someday being in a building where we can just truly feed large numbers of people.
Our biggest thing is how can we do more? How can we reach more kids?
A fully equipped kitchen. We're just gonna go big.
You know, I have a vision of No Nonsense being as big as McDonald's on every corner.
He's making a difference, I know.
I don't consider myself a hero. I just consider myself doing a humane thing as just doing what I do, going out helping people.
Please meet Alvin Jackson, cook at Assurant Cafe in Atlanta, Georgia. Alvin Jackson's commitment to fighting hunger has grown significantly over the years. After 4 years of volunteering weekly with Mount Effin Baptist Church Meal Program, he and his wife founded their own nonprofit, No Nonsense Ministries, to serve the homeless men, women, and children. Understanding that impactful programs require collaboration, Alvin successfully recruited enthusiastic Sodexo employees, clients, and customers. Together, they fight hunger while also collecting and distributing clothes, footwear, bedding, and other critical supplies to the homeless in their community. Since 2006, Alvin has prepared and served almost 70,000 meals to people in his community. Alvin believes that we can do better if we can just get out and get in touch with the community more than we are doing. The question is, how can we do more? How can we reach more kids? Alvin Jackson is a hero of everyday life. Joe Klaus, operations manager at Colby College from Waterville, Maine. Joe fights hunger on many fronts. As a member of Maine's Harvest for Hungry, for the past 3 years, he has committed hundreds of hours and secured 300,000 pounds of fresh produce for local food pantries. His school garden, which he started in 2008, produces about 1,500 pounds of produce that also goes to local food pantries and homeless shelters each year. Since 2011, he has prepared and served about 6,000 meals to the hungry at a local homeless shelter. Joe also teaches community members about nutrition, food preparation, budgeting, and shopping through Share Our Strengths Cooking Matters program. Every year, he also participates in Sodexo's annual Stop Hunger Food Drive, where last year he collected nearly 500 pounds of food. Joe shares, "It's just tragic that 40% of all food grown or raised in the U.S. is not eaten. It's both a terrible shame and an incredible opportunity when you consider the families and the children not certain about the source of their next meal." Joe Klaus is a hero of everyday life.